So as I said, we will start with circular motion today. But before we get into circular motion, also do a couple of revision questions from approach and separation velocity, which is the last thing we had done in the previous lecture. The circular motion's definition is very simple. It is motion in a two-dimensional plane such that the distance from a particular point remains constant. It's called circular motion. The trajectory for such a motion is a circular trajectory. So typically what we do is we take the plane of motion as our xy plane and we take the center of that circular trajectory as our origin. That fixed point from which the distance remains constant is called the center of the trajectory. So if the 2D plane of motion is taken as the XY plane and the center of the circular path is taken as the origin of our system, then if at some instant the particle or the body or whatever is present at a position vector r such that its coordinates are xy, then it should move in such a way that magnitude of r, that is the distance from the origin, is constant. So that means square root of x square plus y square constant. X square plus y square is r square, which is constant. So this is the equation of a circle. And as you know, if we trace that circle or the trajectory of the circle, it will look something like this. So this is the definition of circular motion, and this is the equation of the trajectory for a particle in circular motion. Okay. Particle must describe a path such that every point the particle goes through x comma y satisfies this equation that x square plus y square is a constant which is equal to square of the distance from the origin. Yes, the word trajectory and path, Yash, are interchangeable. You know? So, trajectory is a more like a technical term for the word path. So, just like a projectile has parabolic trajectory, which means the path of the projectile is a parabola. Like that, over here, we are discussing about circular trajectory. And the equation of circular trajectory is given by this one. X square plus y square is equal to r square, where r is constant. Okay. Yes. Now, the next thing we'll discuss about in circular motion is something called the angular parameters. For circular motion. So, as we have seen before, the standard way to describe circular motion is that we take we define the center of the circular path as our origin of our coordinate system, and we define our xy plane such that the motion is happening in the xy plane. So now, having done that, okay, I'll take you back to the diagram. Just give me a moment. So having done that, if at any instant of time the position of our particle is at a particular point on this circle, such that the position vector with respect to the origin is r, so t equal to t, so r is the instantaneous position vector of a particle p at some time t equal to t. Now this particle p is in circular motion. Of radius r and with center O as shown here. Okay. So then we define angular position as theta, where theta is the anti-clockwise, when it is the angle made with respect to the x-axis for the position vector. So angular position is defined as the angle made by the instantaneous position vector with respect to the x-axis, which is our reference axis. Now in this we use a sign convention. If theta is anti-clockwise, it is a positive quantity. If theta is clockwise, it is a negative quantity. So for example, theta equal to plus 45 degrees. Will represent a point like this. Then theta is equal to, let's say, 150 degrees. Will represent a point like this. For example, theta equal to minus 60 degrees, that we represented like this. So this is how we define the angular position. It is the angle made by the position vector with respect to our reference axis, which is our x-axis. So at any instant, whatever angle it is making, following the sign convention that if the angle is positive, it's an anti-clockwise angle. If the angle is negative, it's the clockwise angle with respect to the x-axis. So that effectively, for a given circular motion, if we know the angular position, we can trace where the actual position of the particle is. Because we know its path is circular. So once we know that at a particular instant, it's at so much angle, like I've shown in this diagram here, three different angular positions, I've shown how we can locate the position of the particle in that circle just by knowing the angular position, because the distance from the origin is remaining constant. So angular position itself becomes effectively the position of the particle. It tells us that within that circle, where exactly it is located at that given instant. Okay. So that's why the angular parameters become important in circular motion. We will see as we go along. And the first of the angular parameters is the angular position. So I'm just going back to the earlier section once, those were not finished writing this down, just go through this once. Then we'll come back to the definition of angular position as the first of the angular parameters for the circular motion. Angular parameters, or we can also call them angular variables.
Can you scroll down?
Okay, so let's come back to the definition of the angular parameters or angular variables. In that, the first one, which is the angular position. Okay, so angular position. So we typically denote with the symbol theta. Now one more thing to understand here, that theta is expressed in radians, which is the SI unit. And also that angle or theta is dimensionless. Because that's the way angle is defined, arc upon radius, so it's a dimensionless parameter. Okay, next up, we understand the concept of angular displacement. So angular displacement during a time interval delta t is defined as the change in angular position. During this interval. So basically, if at time t equal to t1, the angular position is theta1, and at t equal to t2, where t2 is t1 plus time delta t, theta is equal to theta2, then angular displacement in time t1 to t2 is delta theta, which is the change in theta, which is theta2 minus theta1. So we can also understand this geometrically or in terms of the visual diagram. So if this is the circular path that the particle or body is describing following the standard sign convention, standard convention that the motion is in the xy plane, okay, with the center as the origin. So if this is the position at time t equal to t1, so at that instant, position vector is r1, which is at an angular position theta1. Okay. Now, in a certain interval of time, if the particle travels from this position to some other position, so it's going on that circular path. So if it reaches here at time t2, where the position vector is now this, such that the angular position now at this point of time is theta 2, then in that time interval t1 to t2, the angular displacement that the particle has covered, that angular displacement will be this one now. This one. This is our angular displacement. So the angular displacement delta theta, find like this. So delta theta is also expressed in radians. Delta theta is dimensionless. And again, the sign convention. Positive means anti-clockwise, negative means clockwise. No, Vedant, the displacement of the particle is not the length of the arc. That is the actual path of the particle. Okay. The displacement is the vector joining the initial and final position. And angular displacement is the change in the angle. So let's understand this with a certain example. So tracing the circular path of the tip of a clock's second hand. Okay. The length of the hand, that is, let us say, 20 centimeters. So, if the clock is like this, such that we are defining our XY axis like this. So these are the markings on the clock. Express the angular position of the second's hand at the time of and therefore, express the angular displacement Okay, so just try this question out, we'll discuss. Yes, you have given the answers, I think, for the minutes hand. Just understand it's for the second hands. So, for example, the time I've given in part E of question 1 is 12 hours, 30 minutes, and 10 seconds. Understood, no?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Yeah, Vedant, it's correct.
So can you scroll up? I want to ask the question.
Okay, now for this given circular path. Which is also in seconds, equal to 10 seconds, 20 seconds, like that. No, sorry. No, it's true. So in seconds, these are 5 seconds, 10 seconds. Like that. So Twelve hours, 30 minutes, and 10 seconds. So the seconds hand will be here. The minutes hand will be here. So the hour. So the minutes hand, okay. So the angular position of the seconds hand will be this. Now you can see that this arc or this will be equal to 30 degrees or pi by 6. Okay, so same way. Now at forty seconds. Our seconds hand would be here. So you can see our angular position and similarly, at 12:35 and 30 seconds, the angular position of the seconds hand will be -π/2. Okay, so this is your first part. The question. Now coming to the angular displacements. Yes, very good. Yes, and Vedant.
It's an answer for A part, sorry. Center.
So angular displacement for the second hand. So the angular displacement is final angular position minus initial angular position. So this is telling me that for that time interval, the final angular position of the second hand is what we've shown in the diagram beside. So it is minus 150 degrees, whereas the initial angular position was plus 5 by 6 or 30 degrees. Okay. So the angular displacement So this is the angular displacement from okay, likewise. The same starting time, but to a different time of 12:31 minutes and what was it? 30 seconds. Just try this out, people. Exactly, Vedan. Don't have to worry about what the minutes or the hours hand has done. We have to just see that the tip of the second hand, as it is describing its own circular path, how the angular position is changing. That is angular displacement. So it doesn't matter that from 12:30 and 10 seconds to 12:31 and 10 seconds, it's actually gone 360 degrees. Okay. Clockwise, and then from there to 30 seconds, I have further, what is it now? A further 60 degrees clockwise. Okay, but we are writing the displacement now, not the angular distance covered. So it is just final position minus initial position. So it will be minus of 60 degrees. This B part as it goes from 10 to 20, you'll see it goes from plus 30 to minus 30. So it'll be minus 60 or minus pi by 3. I'm just going to minimize and scroll up to the question. So now you can also try the third part of the question, which is about the displacement, not angular displacement, but displacement. So you know the definition of displacement from kinematics before, use that.
Sir, is my answer correct for the third one?
Okay, so let's work out the next part now. So angular displacement from 12:10 and 10 seconds, sorry, 12:30 and 10 seconds to 12:30 and 20 seconds. So at this point of time, you can see that the angular position of the minute hand is
minus.
At this point, it is plus 30 and minus 90. So okay, now let's understand the next part. The next part is not related directly to angular parameters, but it's related to the concept of displacement. Okay, so we have to find the displacement of the seconds hand tip from 12:30 and 10 seconds to 12:30 and 20 seconds. So you'll understand that during this interval of time, the seconds hand have markings like this. So the second hand at 12:30 and now reaches
20, sir.
On an equilateral time. T2 is 20 seconds.
So it was 20 seconds.
So this is the angular displacement. It's an angular displacement of
So,
so this is about angular displacement.
Sir, I believe you
now
are
the last part of the question. We have to find the linear displacement, or basically what we just call the displacement. That same point, the tip.
Hello. Sir, the
Yes, if you want to speak, then please unmute yourself and speak. Audio is not coming from your end, but you have unmuted yourself, but there is no audio coming from your end. Yeah, there is some issue from your end. The audio is not coming through. You are unmuted, so should be able to, but there's no audio signal coming from your end. Yes.
No,
just check your internet connection or your audios.
I'm not speaking.
Yeah, the audio is fine from my end. Try again.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Yes, I guess like it was some kind of glitch because we all were speaking, but you were not able to hear.
Yes.
Okay, so any doubt with this right now?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, have you worked out the third part?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so how much is the displacement?
Sir, it's 20 pi by 3.
20 centimeter.
From,
20 centimeter. Displacement is
20, it's 20 centimeters. And what is the direction?
From 10 to 20 centimeters.
But what is the direction of the displacement vector?
Negative, sir.
Negative J cap along the negative
yes,
Y axis.
Negative J cap. Yes.
Yeah, so correct. So see, the tip of the second hand is over here. Let's see, it's over here. This is the tip of the second hand. This is 20 centimeters long. This is the tip of the second hand at 12 hours 30 minutes and 10 seconds. So this angular position is 30 degrees. Okay. Then by the time you come to 40 seconds, the tip has come here. So by the time you come to 20 seconds, the angular position has become minus 30. So the displacement of that point will be this vector. Now you can understand, because this is equal to this, so these two angles become equal, becomes an equilateral triangle. So this displacement, it has a magnitude of 20 centimeters in direction downwards. So displacement of the tip becomes minus 20 j cap in centimeters. So this is clear, people?
Yes.
Okay. So that is about, basically we have discussed about angular displacement and angular position, but we also just included one example where we are calculating the displacement of a point also. And you can see how the concept of angular position helps us in calculating a displacement also. Now let's come to the next angular parameter. So before this question, we have discussed angular position and angular displacement. Now in the general order of kinematics, after displacement, the next thing we generally describe is velocity. So we'll do the same over here. The third angular parameter.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, actually, I'm having a doubt in the second part, the B question, B part.
Okay, I'll explain.
Yes, sir, your own. Sir, here it is.
This one, second question, B part.
Yes.
12:30 and 10 seconds to 12:31 and 30 seconds.
No? Sir, the diagram which you drawn.
So at 12:30 and 10 seconds, the second hand is here. So its angular position is what? This one. So it is how much? It is plus 30 degrees. That is the angular position. And then when it is 12:31 and 30, it should be. Okay, this was the difficulty.
Yes, sir.
So I think in the original question, since T2 is 12 hours, 31 minutes, and 30 seconds.
30.
So the angular position is minus 90. Okay.
That's good.
Now, angular velocity defined as rate of change of angular position. Just like velocity, for example, in 1D motion is defined as rate of change of linear position, dx by dt. Like that, angular velocity, it is defined as, we use the symbol omega for it. So this is the Greek symbol omega. So omega is the instantaneous rate of change of angular position or rate of angular displacement with respect to time. So this is expressed in radians per second, and it is having dimension time inverse and the same sign convention that positive is anti-clockwise and negative is clockwise. So just as an example, you can understand that the angular velocity of the second's hand of a clock assuming it moves uniformly, okay, so it covers 2 pi radians, but clockwise in 60 seconds. Or we can say it's pi by 30, but clockwise. So either we should give the direction in terms of clockwise or anti-clockwise, or we should follow the sign convention that anti-clockwise is positive and negative is clockwise. So this is the simple definition of angular velocity. Now, next thing in the sequence is the final parameter, angular acceleration. So angular acceleration is expressed in radians per second square. It has a dimension of this much.
So you represent acceleration by alpha, right?
Yes. Alpha. But this is angular acceleration, not linear acceleration.
Yes, sir.
Dimensions, the use of it is helps us understanding the units used for a physical quantity and how to compare it with other physical quantities in terms of units and dimensions. So that's the purpose of understanding the dimensions. Just to answer your question, yes, ma'am. Yeah. Okay, now let's understand an example question. So a particle starts from rest at time t equal to zero with a uniform angular acceleration. Let us say pi by 16 radians per second square. So find angular displacement after two seconds.
So it's pi by 16, right?
Yes, pi by 16. Okay. If the radius of the circular path, radius is equal to 1 meter, then find the displacement . Okay, just work this question out quickly.
So then.
Hello, Hello. Hello, sir.
Hello.
Hello. Show me, sir.
Hello,
hello. Hello.
Hello, hello.
Hello, hello.
Hello, sir. We cannot hear you.
Sir is not talking now.
Yes. Hello, sir. Do we have to leave the meeting?
Bye.
Bye, sir.